Hello students, today we are going to discuss brainstorming questions of the drama A Midsummer Night's Dream. In my yesterday's lecture we had seen the story in detail. I have explained to you all the theme, plot and synopsis, means the summary of this particular extract from a well-known novel, that is A Midsummer Night's Dream by William Shakespeare. So today let's discuss with the question answers. Now question number one, choose the odd one out. Now here we can say first one is bottom, moth, mustard, seed and cobweb. Here you should know the characters very well, then only you can answer. The odd one here will be bottom, because bottom is a weaver and the rest are fairies. After that, second one, flute, some quince and cobweb. Here the odd one is cobweb, because cobweb is a fairy and the others are workers. After that, match the column. Here we all know very well now the character. Theseus was who? He was Duke of Athens. Titania, Queen of the Fairies. Puck, Robin Goodfellow. Hippolyta, Queen of the Amazons. And cobweb and moth were fairies. After that, now this, both the questions here, question number 1 and 2, they are objective questions. These two are subjective questions here, children. I will not tell you the answer in detail. I will just tell you in short what you're supposed to write. You have to go through the story and write answer in your own sentence. Now they want you to draw a character sketch of Oberon as an enemy of his wife but a friend of the lovers. Why we can say Oberon was enemy of his wife? Because he refuses to hand over the control of a young Indian boy to whom she refuses to hand over the control of the Indian boy whom he wants, because he wants this boy to be a part of the court and wife is not ready here. So because of that he becomes very angry with his wife, and for that purpose what he does, he tells Puck is his servant, he tells Puck that to bring the love potion and put in Titania's eyes, so that the first person she sees, then she will fall in love with that person. So because when he wanted the Titania, when she wakes up next morning, she wanted her to see Oberon himself only, so that she forgets the Indian boy. And on the other hand, why we can say that he was the lover, friend of the lovers here? Because he feels very bad for Helena, that she, though she loves him very much, she is not getting love of Demetrius. So she tells he tells Puck to help her. And later on what happened, this Puck, when he makes a mistake, instead of putting that love potion in, you can say, Demetrius' eyes, he makes a mistake and he puts that love potion in Lysander's eyes. So there is confusion again. So he gets angry on Puck and he tells Puck to rectify the matter. So here we can say, here, though he is enemy of his own wife, he is friend of the lovers. Next one, comment on the loving pair of Lysander and Helena from the point of view of developing the character. How we come to know they both are loving pair? Actually, these two characters, they are not loving pair here, children. Actually, Lysander is in love with Hermia and Hermia is also in love with Lysander. But here what happened? Because of the mistake of Puck, what happens? Puck, he, instead of putting that love potion in this one, Demetrius' eyes, he puts in Lysander's eyes. And when he wakes up next morning, Lysander, he sees Helena, and that's why he is in love with Helena. Actually, he is in love with Hermia only. Because of the love potion, here you can say he is in love with Helena. And afterwards, what happened when Hermia realizes that both the male characters, both Lysander and Demetrius, instead of loving her, now they both love Helena. So she quarrels with her friend Helena. And here we also come to know that Shakespeare had shown, or he has tried to tell us, that the love of, or you can say power of love, is very much, and it can overcome loyalty here. And he has also shown you can say how strong jealousy can be. She becomes very jealous of Helena, so that's why she quarrels with her. So that we come to know from this particular story here. You can answer in your own words. Setting: the play is restricted to only the part of the woods. We can also say that it is restricted to only one part of the wood because the play is spread over the portion of the wood everywhere. You can say at one point the four lovers wander everywhere, and Oberon and Pup too are in, also in the different part of the wood. So it is not restricted to only one part of the wood, one part of the forest. It is spread all over. And afterwards, since there is a reference to the Indian boy, there are some scenes from India too. No, though there is reference in the play to the for the Indian boy here, there are no scenes from India. We come to know. The next one, the characters are a part of the stage setting. How does this reflect when the characters of the play range from Duke and the Indian boy to the fairies? Here we have seen, we have gone through the story. We come to know everything that it is mainly this drama is set in the ancient Athens and the wood just outside the Athens here. So what happened? He just changes this place into a magic place with fairies and all. And we all come to know that Athens is a strict. In Athens there is very strict law and order. And Duke, he is being the king. He is very strict here. He wants everyone to obey whatever he tells. And he also tells Hermia that he will punish her if she doesn't listen to her father here. And we all come to know about the fairies and how he puts the love potion into the eyes of the characters and all. So because of that, we can say they both the things, the setting and the characters, they both are or you can say both setting and characters reflect each other. Now, what changes in the stage setting would you suggest here? Now we can say there in this particular story there is magic, love potion, fairies, dreams and cures in the plot, lot of confusion in the plot. The woods are an extremely suitable setting to show all this confusion. So here we can say there are no changes required. It is appropriate here. The fourth question, that is comment on the versatility of and the aptness of the stage setting as per the requirement of the play. So we can say yes, it is very apt. The entire wood, we come to know the four, you can say lovers are at one part, Oberon and Puck are in the one part, and all confusion is going on. So it is very suitable here. You can just explain with the example related to characters and all. After that, plot. State whether the following statement are true or false. Lysander and Demetrius fall in love with Helena as a result of love potion here. Yes, because of the love potion they fall in love with Helena. Actually they both are in love with whom? They both are in love with Hermia. Oberon transform Bottom's head into that of an ass? No, it is false. Oberon does not transform. It is Perk who transform Bottom's head into an ass. Then Titania falls in love with an ass? No, she does not fall in love with an ass. She falls in love with Bottom because of that love potion. She is actually not in love. Because of that love potion, everything has happened. So it is false. Then both Demetrius and Lysander fight for Hermia. Here you can say no, it is false. They are not fighting here for Hermia. They are fighting here for Helena. After that, give reason. Oberon and Titania fight for the custody of the Indian boy. Oberon and Titania. We all know Oberon is the king and Titania is the queen of fairies. They both are fighting for the custody of the Indian boy. Why? We can say why Oberon is fighting. Because he wants that boy. He wants that boy to become the part of his court here. And the other thing is that he is also jealous of the affection which Titania shows for that Indian boy. So that's why he wants that boy from Titania. And on the other hand, Titania, she wants the custody of the boy, you can say, because she has promised the mother of that boy that she will look after that boy very nicely. So that's why she wants the custody, you can say. After that, कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज ऑफ ओबेरॉन्स जेलेसी फॉर टिटानिया और कॉमिक रादर देन ट्रेजिक. यस यू कैन से ओबेरॉन्स जेलेसी फॉर टिटानिया इज कॉमिक ओनली, यू कैन से हियर. Why? Because first, as he is jealous that Titania is showing lot of love for that Indian boy, she is not showing that much love and affection for him, and she is not giving the custody of that boy to him. So because of that, he feels very jealous, and he tells Puck to bring that love potion and put in her eye so that she forgets that Indian boy and all that story you all know very well. But later on, when he realizes that. Instead of looking him or when she wakes up after that love potion in her eye, she looks bottom, and that bottom also he has this perk. What he has done, he has put that ass head to that bottom's character bottom here. So she starts feeling attracted towards that bottom with an ass head. So he feels that he didn't want the situation to get more worse or tragic. So what he tells Puck to rectify the matter here. So this is, you can say, more comic than being tragic here. All thing confusion and this thing is going on here. Now there were some reasons why Theseus was initially against, but later gave consent to the marriage of Helena with Lysander. Now here we have to, here they are asking you, first he was not ready for the marriage of Helena and Lysander, but later on he, here you can say, they are saying that he gives consent here. So here you can say, first this king, he is very you can say person who follows laws and order, and we all know that Hermia wants to marry Lysander, but her father Aegeus wants her to marry Dermatius. And Theseus, as the Duke of Athens, is powerful character and he represents law. He has the power to decide when there is a disagreement. So hence Aegeus takes Hermia to him, and for according to the Athenian law, the father has the right to decide who his daughter should marry. Hence, following the law and Aegeus' wishes, Theseus was against Hermia's marriage to Lysander, and later on the Duke relents when he sees the love between Helena and Dermatius, and happily allows Hermia to marry Lysander, you can say. Instead of this thing, Helena here, it should be Hermia. After that, see here, select the correct option. A Midsummer Night's Dream is a poetic drama, or a comedy of errors, comedy based on fantasy, a character play, revenge tragedy, a play belongs to a realm of dreams. So after going through the story and discussing all question answer, children, I hope that you all know very well that it is a poetic drama, it is comedy of errors, you can say it is comedy based on fantasy because all magic potion, fairies and all are mentioned here, and a play that belongs to realm of dreams here also, we can say. Now find 2 to 4 expression of humor. So many lot of confusion sentences are there here, that how the characters, the love potion, instead of this person's eye, it's put in the other person's eye and all those things. So just go through the text and write down 2, 3, or 4 expression of humor here. A Midsummer Night's Dream is one of the best example of Shakespeare comedy of errors. Yes, very well. It is one of the best, we can say, because we have seen that there is lot of confusion in the story here related to the character, one person falling in love with other, the other person getting attracted towards other person, the third person and all. So we can say it is the best example. Afterwards, Shakespeare is acknowledged as the greatest writer because he understood human nature better than anyone else. Yes, he has, we can say, because here we come to know one thing, that first, though the theme of this story is love, but still we can see here the other feeling of human beings, like being jealous. Now this Oberon is jealous of his wife, then some other person, you can say, when Hermia realizes that both the male characters, Dermatius and Lysander, instead of loving her, now they love Helena, so she is jealous of her friend. So we can say how the human characters are very nicely portrayed in the story here. Now prove with the theme of the play, extract the deeper humor, you may show profoundly interested Shakespeare was jealous. Yes. though this is love theme, jealousy is also nicely portrayed here. I have told you how it has been portrayed through the characters. Just go through and write the answer in your own sentence. After that, interpret the following lines in simple English. So here you can say, Puck. Here they have mentioned, Puck, I'll follow you. So in simple English, you can say, Puck says that he would follow him or her. Next one, Bottom, the finch, the sparrow. Now here in simple English, we can say, Bottom sings about the finch and the sparrow. After that, comment on the literary device. First one, be kind and courteous to this gentleman. Here the literary device used is tautology, because the words having same meaning, courteous and kind, are used in the same line. Come, wait upon him, lead him to my bower. Here you can say literary device is imperative sentence, because it is an order of command sentence here. After that, Shakespeare poetry has come to be valued of its own sake on the stage. Comment with reference to the play. You have to say here how very nicely this play had been shown in a poetical form. We have gone through the text, we have seen. Though this is story, it has been told to us in a very poetic form. So just give examples from there and try to explain how it has been told to you all. You have to write answer in your own words. I hope you have understood it for today. I'll stop here. Thank you.